Today we have with us Srijit Mukherjee, and we will be talking to him about his childhood, his journey as a filmmaker, and his future projects. Hello Srijit, welcome to SholoanaBangaliana.com. Srijit, we have heard a lot about your movies, how your progress and all, but we hardly know much about your childhood. So let's start way back. So, Dolna-dey school and then South Point. So,
yes, I was born in Bhawanipur, that is the area Kolkata, which kind of bridges the south and the north. Kolkata sensibilities, architecture, way of living, and everything. Mm-hmm. So those were very, very interesting years. Jagatake bola hobe cinema para, because chaidike prochur cinema hoyechilo. So there was Indira, Bharati, Bijoli, Purno, and also Boshishri, Unchalan, Kalita nearby. So Shatta cinema hall more or less in the vicinity. So I grew up in an atmosphere of night show bhanga and evening show bhanga, low, and it was a very Shahrukh-Khan baby, it's called Indira Road, Indira cinema, thick question. I have very fond memories of the para where I grew up, and I was there till the age of 15. And that way, upon jono when I revisit those lanes and my lanes, how interesting lagi. Mona hai kiram shrink kore the shop kichu. Actually, I have grown up, so that change in visual perspective sort of is very interesting for me whenever I revisit those things.
Right. So along with the cinema para, barite ki influence chilo?
Barite influence is maa baba pochondo gaan bajna cinema, natok, kovita, itadi ekta porivesh chilo. My father is a singer here. My mother is a student of Kollagi, Shekhar Royal. So my father is a published poet as well.
Yes.
So Shamili, it was a very culturally active household.
Okay.
You know, my cinema dakha best of a lot is due to my father, who used to encourage me to watch like all possible kinds of films.
Sure.
So she can be that.
Okay. So your mom has got this thing of connecting tortoises.
Yes,
yeah, we can see them here. Yeah. Yes. So any particular passion that you have on those similar lines?
I collect stories.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that we all know.
Stories from life, and I draw stories from life, and characters, stories, events, drama, life, death, love, compassion, revenge, serial killing, everything fascinates me.
Okay.
So, I collect stories.
Cool. So, school er pore presidency. And said presidency te prem porashona politics.
Prem porashona is actually presidency te ke JNU te beshi hoy.
That would be my next.
Kintu presidency te hoto. Presidency te bolo presidency te bolo onno rokom presidency te. আমাদের ক্যান্টিন অনার্স বলতে আমরা ক্যান্টিনেই বেশি অনেক সময় কাটতো, সেখানে গান বাজনা আড্ডা প্রেম অবস্থ নেশা ভাঙ এইসব আর কি. JNU is an experience which is, apart from the Pesci experience, the most life-changing experience for me. It changed the entire world for me. It opened up doors which hitherto I did not know existed, and it gave me a perspective to life, to politics, to women, to academics, to films, anything. I mean, anything and everything. JNU made me sort of develop an opinion on that, and it was fantastic. And JNU Sriti Gulo is something which is probably the closest to my heart in terms of my past. And the campus is, I mean, I'm totally, still totally in love with the campus, and even half a chance and chute jaye.
Delhi campus life is fantastic. Alright, so after college, IRI Symphony, your professional life and everything.
College, after university.
After university, right, sorry.
And I did my master's and my MPhil, and I was in my first year PhD when IRI Symphony happened.
So tar sathe sathe to theater lo cholchilo.
Theater
cholchilo. Office
chose,
you know, any outrageous office
bunking
exclusive
you might. No, I didn't, because I loved what I did.
Okay.
I loved econometrics, I loved statistical modeling,
okay.
And I went to Milan, worked there for some time, came back to Bangalore, and I did both side by side, so there was no bunking. There were inhuman working hours or inhuman hours of, so I used to finish my office, go to the rehearsals for my play, sit for the 2 and 3 hours of rehearsal, set up the production, come back to office, work, then go home very late at night, catch probably 2-3 hours of sleep and then come back again. So it was a very strenuous life, but I enjoyed it because I loved both my work and my
You've
passion.
Been honest to both, your yes. passion as well yes. as your profession. That's yes. wonderful. So after I Rise Simply, when you decided to shift to Kolkata into this regional industry, cinema industry rather, it was like a calculated risk. So if I may ask, what calculations actually?
There were no calculations. It was not a calculated risk. It was like about a bungee jumping. I was bungee jumping without probably a string because yeah. I knew no one and I've never seen a film camera before.
Mm-hmm.
I knew how to write or how to stage plays because I've done that for some time.
Yeah, thank you.
When I quit my job, I was tired of the same and I knew somewhere I felt that I wanted to tell stories and make a difference to people's lives.
Mm-hmm.
People's lives. So, which was one of the driving reasons for me quitting my job. And when I came to Kolkata, which is a lot of aspirations, a lot of confidence in one's capability, but precious little to show in terms of contacts or calculations or plan Bs or turn back options.
Okay.
So it was more like a plunge which I took, and I gave myself a kind of a time period. If nothing happens, I'd probably shift to cricket journalism or wildlife photography.
Alright, so that is another of your interest areas?
Yes.
Okay, cool. So, I have read in one of your interviews, you said that you watched a lot of Bangla movies to understand the filmmaker and audience interaction. So, what analysis?
No, I didn't actually watch them to understand anything. I watched them because I enjoyed watching movies.
Okay, not for any understanding of...
Film watching was, and filmmaking as well,
mm-hmm.
it's always been an act of sheer pleasure.
Okay.
There is no motive, there is no message, there is no claim, there is no drive to prove anything to anyone. It's just, I enjoy doing it. I
okay.
do things which I enjoy doing. The day I stop enjoying, I stop doing that thing.
Okay.
So, yeah. So, some point of time, I enjoyed crunching numbers and doing statistical modeling. After a point of time, I stopped. So, I shifted to storytelling on cellular.
Okay.
So, if I ever get tired of storytelling on cellular, I'll shift to something else. So, it's as simple as that.
Okay.
Again, when I used to watch film, probably Bangla. Bangla, English, Hindi, Irish, Polish, Tamil, Telugu, German. So, whatever. Maybe it was more for entertainment and enjoyment. In, provoking my thoughts, provoking sensibilities in me. যে কারণে মানুষ সিনেমা দেখে আমি সেই কারণে দেখতে হ্যাঁ অ্যাজ এ বাই প্রোডাক্ট আই লার্ন টু লট অফ থিংস মানে আই ওয়াচ মাস্টার্স ওয়ার্কিং ইন ফিল্মস এন্ড নারেটিং স্টোরিজ থ্রু দ্য মুভি পিকচার আই লার্ন আ লট অফ থিংস বাট দ্যাট ইজ মোর লাইক আ বাই প্রোডাক্ট লাইক মাই কমার্শিয়াল box office success is a byproduct.
Okay.
Like the critical acclaim, the festival rounds is a byproduct.
Mm-hmm.
They're good, I'm happy they come, but I don't have an eye on them or I don't make movies for that.
That's interesting.
If it comes, good enough. If it doesn't come, I can't help it. I intend to tell my stories exactly the way I want to.
Okay.
Because I enjoy watching them.
Mm-hmm.
That is why I tell stories.
Okay.
So if a lot of people enjoy them along with me, good. If they don't, I'm sorry. But that's the way it's going to be. The only thing is that who matters to me, whose opinion matters to me or whom I would like to really impress,
mm-hmm.
apart from myself, myself is first. I would like to impress myself with whatever I make and whatever I want to watch. Yeah, only other person is my producer.
Mm-hmm.
Because that guy is investing his hard-earned money in my dreams,
mm-hmm.
which he has no business doing.
Mm-hmm.
But he's still doing it.
Yeah.
He's being nice to me.
Yeah.
So I should be nice to him. I also wanted to add something to that. I mean, again, the only two people who matter to me is me and the producer. But that doesn't mean that if the producer says that do it my way, I do it his.
Mm-hmm.
I exactly will do things my way. I will only hope that the producer likes it.
Okay.
And if the producer doesn't like it,
mm-hmm.
and if he If he feels that I'm not his guy, then we go for an honorable breakup. But then I go for another producer, as simple as that.
Okay.
But luckily till now, mm-hmm. my association with people have been very fruitful because they have been people of the same wavelength.
Right.
So I've never had to worry that, I mean, apart from minor things, mm-hmm. but over, by and large, philosophically,
mm-hmm.
I have worked with the two producers I've worked with till now, they have been in unison. So
right.
I was just attending a debate or seminar on independent films yesterday on SRFK. So that was my point, as in, independent film, I call my films independent because the producers never interfere or say that you have to put in this, you have to put in that and make it like this.
Mm-hmm.
One reason probably they don't do it with me, at least, is because they know that the kind of person I am, mm-hmm. what I do, somehow finds a lot of takers, finds a lot of audience, mm-hmm. and people generally tend to like them more than dislike them.
Mm-hmm.
So they tend to go with my vision or tend to go with my sensibility.
Mm-hmm.
But, for example, if they do come up and tell me that, look, you have to change your sensibility, I would back out of that project, because if I change my sensibility and make a film,
mm-hmm.
it will be neither here nor there, it will
yeah.
be even worse.
Yeah.
So, so that is something that I want to sort of add when I say that the producer is important. Well, he is definitely important to me, and it matters to me what his opinion is.
Mm-hmm.
But not at the cost of my individuality in television.
So is it why we see a new producer with your films these days?
No, absolutely not. The thing is, it might so happen that there could be other constraints.
Right.
A producer might not like my casting.
Mm-hmm.
A producer might not like my choice of music director.
Mm-hmm.
That could also be a reason. My producer might not like Kobi Gaan.
Yeah.
So that's good enough reason. And if he doesn't like Kobi Gaan, I can't hold him at gunpoint and say you have to love Kobi Gaan.
Absolutely.
I mean, there are lots of people who don't like Kobi Gaan.
Yeah.
But we are great friends.
Mm-hmm.
Those people and we are great friends.
Absolutely.
So it's like that. And with Srikant and Moni, we are such great friends. It doesn't really matter if they don't agree with the casting or they don't agree with the music director of a project or they agree with the whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say they don't agree with
yeah.
the philosophy or the principle of a story or a movie.
Mm-hmm.
Fine, I mean.
The personal stance is absolutely different from the professional.
I will work with someone else.
Right.
Simple as that.
Yeah.
Because if I'm convinced yeah. about what I want and they are convinced about what
they want.
If they don't coincide, in most cases they
yeah.
do.
Yeah.
But in some cases, if they don't coincide, I will go and look for another producer
right.
with whom it does match or mm-hmm. does coincide. So, like similarly, I don't agree with a lot of films SVF does.
Right.
And then I'm also a great fan of some films that they do.
Yeah.
So that means what? That means that it's not necessarily that it has to be 100% coincidence of what I feel should be a movie and what they feel should be a movie. But even if these two versions don't match, it's doesn't really matter because at the end of the day, we are still great friends.
We're all in the industry, we're working together.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's not like that SVF only works with me.
No, definitely.
So,
yeah. But then again, you know, they've been strongly associated with the new.
So have the Anupam Rai, so
yeah.
have Bumrah.
Right.
But my point, which every time I have to answer a question that why am I not working with Anupam Rai?
Right.
Or why am I not working with SVF?
Mm-hmm.
Or why am I not working with Prasenjit-Chatterjee? Or why am I not working with parambrata-chetterjee or this. My point is, boss, all these people, Prasenjit-Chatterjee, Anupam Rai, SVF, Shomi Khalda, Devojyoti Mishra, Bodhai Tomandabhadai, everyone works with everyone else.
Exactly.
So why should I be any exception?
True. Yeah. Right. So, Srijit, you said that you make movies for your own personal gratification and satisfaction.
Absolutely.
But then in the industry, people also consider you as a great, marketing brain. I mean, you understand the commerce of cinema.
No, I'm just plain lucky. and that luck will run out in probably 1 year or a couple of years, and then they will tell me, I told you so. So I'm saying there is a core of marketing and that there is no formula.
Yeah.
You can't crack human minds like that.
Okay.
If you crack Balurghat, Asansol will laugh at you. If you crack South City, Forum will laugh at you. There is no standard homogeneous formula for success. The only thing you can do,
mm-hmm.
my advice to everyone, If you want to make a successful film, make a film which you would watch yourself going to an auditorium and paying for the ticket.
That's funny.
Just make a film which you would love watching. Yeah. And keep your fingers crossed, hope that there are lots of people like you. Okay. If they're not...
So Srijit Mukherjee doesn't have a set formula, as people say.
Yes, he does. Okay. His only set formula is he pleases himself. If he himself is pleased with what he's watching or he's satisfied, then his job is done.
Okay.
The rest, it's totally random and stochastic.
Okay.
Totally random.
Wonderful. So, cinema hocche cholche, apni kichu korcho. Pandora's act ki holo? What happened to
Pandora's act ta bondho hoye gelo because the cinema's sathe ota na manage kora jacchilo na. Ebong natok ta is a full time association. I do not want to dabble in theater as some people would like to, because I don't think theater is a medium which can be dabbled in. Either you do theater or you don't do theater. Dabbling in theatre is, I think, derogatory for the medium, and I don't want to do that because I am basically from the stage.
Yeah.
I still feel the final, the highest pinnacle of any performance, acting-wise, can only happen on stage.
Okay.
I mean, which is why even after watching thousands of Al Pacino films, I get goosebumps when I watch him perform Shylock in a Broadway production in New York. Or I was Naseer doing a Dear Lad or Ismat Aba Ke Naam. It still gives me goosebumps, and I think that sort of completes an actor, or completes the actor's range of performance. So I do not want to insult or
play with a medium by saying I want to
dabble in theater.
Yeah.
When I'll have proper time, if I get tired of filmmaking and bungee jumping and wildlife photography and cricket journalism, I'll probably do theater.
Okay, that's wonderful. Great. So from here we come to again back to cinema.
Yeah.
Movie baishe-srabon. I mean, the name as such. You know, people have said that this was just to play on the Bengali sentiment, the date and the name. So
people used to say that.
Yeah.
Till the film got released. In fact, a lot of people asked me, why have named it baishe-srabon? Why have named it baishe-srabon? What I said that, look, I might not be the greatest storyteller who ever lived, but I'm also not an idiot. So there has to be some thinking.
Yeah, absolutely.
So please wait for a few days, let the movie release, then watch the movie, then you will get your answer.
Right.
And all those people who badgered me saying why is it baishe-srabon, they got their answer. They,
yeah.
After that, no one asked me, because they knew that I would counter, could you have named it Ponoriyagal? Given the structure of the script,
right.
Could you have named it Pochishu December? Could you have named it Paula Misha? You couldn't have.
Right.
That
is with the script.
That was the logic of the script, made the title inevitable.
Right.
But Baishe-srabon is probably one film which cannot have been titled anything else.
Okay.
You couldn't have titled it whatever.
So it was simply the script and no manipulation with the Bengali sentiment.
Manipulation with the Bengali sentiment would only come if you actually feel that there is a Bangaliana attached somewhere in Baishe-srabon, which any Bengali thing or Bengali pet topic or anything is being tickled.
Right.
The problem is Baishe-srabon is something which is quite anti the concept of the genteel Bengali bhadralok. The film goes against. Not only the question of slangs, it's also the ethos of the film. It is very non-genteel, non-bhadralok. In fact, when I made Baishe-srabon, I did not think a lot of bhadraloks would watch the film. You know, I was very pleasantly surprised when the censor board said that, okay, you have an uncut film, just give it an A. I was like, yes, obviously, I mean, thank you so much. So the thing is, Bengali sentimental prashna actually Baishe-srabon ko ta ashena, because the simple reason that the language in which people speak in the film and the language of the film itself, you know, the grotesque murders and killings and this and that, probably the only thing which was remotely close to tickling of Bengali sentiment was the kovita. And then or there also, I'm sorry to say, but a lot of people don't actually dig Bina Mojumdar a lot. You know, at least the multiplex going audience. A lot of people don't dig. They probably have heard of, you know, Rabindranath Tagore being a cool poet. I mean, Akonka generation, the national anthem, but beyond Tagore, Maybe Jivananda Dash, because of the iconic Bhoomal Darshan. But beyond these two, very few people actually which is why novels and short stories sell much more broadly than poetry. It's a very glamorous thing. My intellectuals are digging that, but the cinema crowd, the cinema audience, where baishe-srabon appeal. তার মধ্যে এই প্রত্যেকটা কবির বডি অফ ওয়ার্ক নিয়ে যে সবাই খুব সচেতন ছিল এরকম নয়। সো ইট ওয়াজ নট রিয়েলি এ কোয়েশ্চন অফ টিকলিং মানে রিসেপশন অ্যাজ আই সেড ইনএভিটেবিলিটি আই মিন বাইশ্রাবণ কুড নট হ্যাভ বিন নেমড এনিথিং এলস বিকজ অফ দ্য স্ট্রাকচার অফ দ্য স্ক্রিপ্ট ওকে সো আফটার
বাইশ্রাবণ দেন movies followed and all. So now we come to Jatishya, yeah. Worked with Kobi Shimon.
Yep.
A hard taskmaster, really tough to work with, mm-hmm. Was it? Or how?
Shumanda is a thorough professional. I had a very, very tough time convincing him to do this actually. That took a lot of time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, going to him and repeatedly saying that, mm-hmm. Shumanda, no one can pull this off, mm-hmm. without you. Like, this is you, this is it. Mm-hmm. I wrote a full-fledged script when a song grew inside me, and that song is yours.
Yeah.
And so I can't make this film without you. And you'll have to, be there. And I have to use your songs. It's not only about Jatishya, it's also about Eitumi Kamuntumi. It's also about Shahashari Lekhi. It's also about Khuda Kasam. And Khuda Kasam, he was like, I will not. It's too personal a song. I shall not allow that to be used. But finally, I badgered him into. So he, in fact, wrote 5 new stanzas for the song, which is something which my Chuddhavushti will be, thankful to him about.
Yeah.
But if not anything else, people, when I die, people will remember me for making a film where Khuda Kasam Jaan Ami Bhalobashi Tomay was used. Or making a film where Kobi Shimon set tune to 22 songs. So, that probably is my bus ride to immortality, through the alleys of Shumanda's song or whatever. But the thing is, that's the thing. I mean, I told Shumanda, I badgered him, I tried to convince him, and finally he agreed. But after he agreed, he turned around the songs in what, 7 days?
Okay.
All the songs, and the recording and the harmony and everything. And then Indrajit Dasgupta, the musical prodigy that he is, and he was fantastic.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And he just arranged brilliantly well. And
music is indeed brilliant. My 1.5-year-old daughter, she sleeps listening to Yetumi.
Yeah.
So that is definitely wonderful.
Yes.
So Jatishyar collections kamon chilo.
Jatishyar collections were very slow to begin with. Yes. The first week were actually very disappointing. We had expected much more. But there are lots of reasons for that. When I said we had expected, I could not bring myself, because mm-hmm. I knew that you are releasing your film in a non-festive period.
Mm-hmm.
That too, on the day of your release, Shuchitra Sen dies. So for the next 1 or 2 or 3 days, Bengalis are generally in a state of mourning. And everyone is stuck to the television who is going on. So the first week I thought would be weak.
Mm-hmm.
And that is precisely what happened. But from the second week, it picked up.
Yeah.
It picked up, and though it didn't go on to become another Mishra-Rosh,
mm-hmm.
definitely it is. It did much better business than a lot of other films which were released in the non-festive season,
mm-hmm.
In the last 3 to 4 years.
But then Jatishyar, is it doing comparatively better in the US and Singapore?
It is doing much better in the US and doing in the sense the first 2 weeks.
Yes, indeed.
Mm-hmm. So the opening was. Singapore had 2 houseful weeks,
yes.
Absolute chock-a-block.
Yes.
And it's doing fantastically well in the US as well. And the domestic circuit, as I said, actually what went in its favor was the tremendous word of mouth.
Yeah.
I have not seen such kind of a word of mouth for any Bengali film in recent years.
Mm-hmm.
The kind of euphoric feedback that it still keep on getting,
it's
even
still
today. The reviews, I mean, people took up pens and keyboards to write reviews which are probably better than the film. Seriously, I mean.
Yeah, we keep seeing those reviews every day.
Absolutely. I was totally overwhelmed. And one reason why the business sort of really picked up from the second week is because of these continuous word of mouth.
Mm-hmm.
Which is why it is still, it's just got into its 7th week.
Yeah.
I went yesterday to South City. It was like 60 to 65% full.
Mm-hmm.
There's such a brilliant thing And that too, a comparatively late night show, and which was something which I was like, okay, so fine, great, it's
so working. You know,
it's the graph, mm-hmm. can be compared to the graph of a bhooter-bhabisyat mm-hmm. or a Ichhe, mm-hmm. you know, which picked up from the second, third, mm-hmm. like bhooter-bhabisyat picked up from the fourth week. Mm-hmm. Ichha picked up from the third week, mm-hmm. so Jadisha picked up from the second, third week, mm-hmm. Due to the great word of mouth. Mm-hmm. So finally the business will come, it will be very good for a film, mm-hmm. for a kind of a niche film I would call it, because Kobigan is something which is not really very
explored
and it's, yeah, it doesn't have a lot of resonance in today's youth, like let's say Rong Pom Rai album or whatever. So, but Shaituna is fantastic.
For a film to be actually successful, it has to do well overseas. I mean, all films, right?
Yeah.
So, what steps do you think? I mean,
no, not only
global audience.
Not only overseas. It's more like how many people have watched it.
Watched and repeatedly.
Correct. So people have come up and told me they have watched Jadu Show 8 times, mm-hmm. 10 times, unheard number of. Repeat wins I have got for Jadisha. The only film which I have seen in recent times, two other films would be baishe-srabon and bhooter-bhabisyat, mm-hmm. which have gone this
such
kind of a such a frenzy,
okay.
In terms of repeat viewing and stuff. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about urban mainstream films.
Yeah, definitely.
I mean, obviously there's a bhojana-shabhojana, mm-hmm. But I'm talking about urban mainstream mm-hmm. films. Mm-hmm. Fantastic. I was slightly to bone crabble, because not because of anything else, because as I said, for me, box office is a bonus. Happens to an extent, doesn't happen to that extent, can't be done. Nothing can be done. But Amachramatology, the producers, especially after Mishra, but I told them that look, you can't compare a Mishra with a Jadisha. Mishra is releasing on Pujo, which is the biggest festive season for the Bengalis, and Pujo show and release Kochya, you have no other Hindi films, and for example, the Jadisha, there was pressure of Jai Ho, in terms of showtimes and Malikai. So you have no pressure of any other Hindi film, so you can't compare a business of Jadisha.
Jadisha is absolutely a different kind of movie.
It's not a populist film.
Yes.
It does not have that reach which Mishra Rao show has, which appeals to everyone from 8 to 80.
Absolutely.
Jadisha it is probably my finest film, according to myself, but its appeal is not as populist as Mishra.
Absolutely.
So you should compare Jadisha with Hemlock Society in terms of my films. Okay. And then you will see that business-wise they're comparable and they've done very well.
Okay.
And another thing is Hemlock was also released in a non-festive season.
Yeah.
Which is why, you know, the comparison makes sense. Hemlock, bhooter-bhabisyat, Ichhe, mm-hmm. Jadisha. These are all films which have done majorly well at the box office, having released in the non-festive season.
Yeah, since you were talking about Mishra, your casting of Indraneel as Hani Alkari, what made you cast him? Because in the book, he's an absolutely different kind of a character, different looking character.
No, not really. In the book, Hani Alkari's description is almost the perfect classical features a man can have, looking almost like a hero. There I paraphrase Ashwin that. And a very heroic, very Greek god kind of sculpted kind of a guy is the description of Hani Alkari. I think Indraneel fits the bill perfectly. And more importantly, what I thought was he needed to be someone who didn't look Bengali and needed to look cosmopolitan and possibly international. And in Indro's contours on his face, his jawline and everything, his body and his physique and the frame and everything, I find a lot of internationalism. As in, you can't really look at Indro and say, "Hey, to Bengali."
Mm-hmm.
He's not the typical Bengali looking guy, which is why I kind of.
Yeah, definitely. Because he got, a lot of praises from all around.
That character was super great.
So now your next movie, Shahrukh-Khan, working with directors, industry stalwarts, experience. So
fantastic experience. We had a blast. Mm-hmm. We had a blast. It was almost like working with 100 years of Bengali cinema, you know. Aparna-sen, gautam-ghoshe, parambrata-chetterjee, all possible kinds of Bengali cinema were represented in that quadrangle. So we had a blast. Pochondo maja hoyeche anta
hoyechi kintu chotushkar er majar sathe chotushkar to onek gulo I think bolte gele frustrations hoyto
jodi chotushkar is probably the mane the most frustrating journey in terms of a film being made because right. I have been planning it from 3 years and I wrote it after autograph mm-hmm. and Rituda tohon protine sokale we had we used to have these long chats mm-hmm. about the script and other things under the sun to she চতুষ্কোণ গিয়ে আজকে এখন হলো তার মধ্যে ওয়ান ডেথ ঋতুদা লেফট আস ইন দ্য ডে অ্যান্ড অঞ্জুমদা পুলড আউট কৌশিকদা পুলড আউট
again
কৌশিক দা কেম ইন ফর অ্যানাদার পার্টিকুলার রোল তো এইগুলো মিলে ইট ওয়াজ আচ্ছা শ্রমিক কুডন্ট বি আ পার্ট অফ ইট বোথ আর পুলড আউট সো রিভার্সালস অল অ্যারাউন্ড অ্যান্ড সেটার মধ্যে কোথাও একটা গিয়ে ইউ But then again, I this happened in Mishore also, when some people wanted to sort of put a spanner in Mishore and mm-hmm. created a rift between me and Mumbala. Mm-hmm. I said, oh, achha, if that is the case, then I will do Mishore, and I will do Mishore, period, irrespective. And there were lots of people who used to tell me, Mumbala doesn't want to do it, but some others, I said, no, I have planned it in a way, I will do it exactly that way. Okay. And that is happened with Chorushkun also. The moment someone tries to stall something or put a roadblock in front of me, I get doubly stubborn and doubly
determined. I'll do it.
And very good. And the great thing is that I found a lot of brave hearts who were there as colleagues in that fight. And they said, no, Srijit, we'll do it. Yeah, we will absolutely do it.
But then you have to change the script, I guess.
Yes, I had to rewrite the script to accommodate Chiranjit and Parambrata.
Yeah, exactly.
I had to rewrite the two characters.
Right, you had to.
But the structure remained the same. Mm-hmm.
So who's doing the music for?
Anupam.
Okay,
Anupam is back.
Okay, Anupam is back. Again, that would have been the other question. Yes. Can Anupam at the main key?
No, but then again, it depends on the project. So mm-hmm. I thought. ID as an Indradeep, mm-hmm. he was apt for Mishore also, its scale, its epic grandeur and everything. I thought Jatishar Kulin had been made without Kobi Shuma.
Right.
So it's, see, music is also a matter of casting. Mm-hmm. Casting someone as you feel fit for the job and stuff.
As you've already said before, it's just what the script demands, what the movie demands.
Absolutely.
Nothing
it's
personal.
Absolutely. It's the same like with Shikhan, Moni, Bumbada or Paro.
Exactly.
My personal relationship with Anupam will not change if I don't work with him in a particular project. Or for that matter with Shomik or for that matter with any of my regular, mm-hmm. so-called regular. The point is, the first team that you work with is usually, you know, given that tag that,
yeah,
okay, this is the team.
This person's team, it happens.
You
have been specially put under the scanner, like, okay, Srijit Kashyap kaaj korche, ki hocche, what is happening?
Exactly, and for example, I like working with other people and that includes the scriptwriter and the story writer as well. So, you will see films in which I have not worked. I've already seen one, Mishore Rosh, yeah, where I've not worked with my story. You will also see films where I will not even be the main scriptwriter. I will work with other scriptwriters also.
Right.
Because I will drop myself also from my team. The scriptwriter Srijit Mukherjee shall also be dropped from the team because the director Srijit Mukherjee needs to work with different people.
Yeah.
And preferably people who are better than him so that he can learn things.
Absolutely.
So there will be films where the scriptwriter will be someone else, there will be films where the DOP will be someone else, producer will be someone else, actor, music director. So
the ultimate goal is a good cinema.
Ultimate goal is good cinema and a process which is enjoyable for the director.
Okay. So along with movie Srijit, you also love cricket, don't you?
Along with cricket, I also love movies.
Oh, okay.
Let's put it that
other way around.
Yeah.
So now, what do you have to say about Shahrukh Khan's recent doing of not involving any cricketer from Bengal into KKR? Hard feelings about that?
Definitely, I thought Lakshmi-Ratan-Shukla should have been there in the team because of his recent form and definitely even Mohammad Shami.
Mm-hmm.
So, I I don't know. I see, obviously they must be having some kind of a roadmap.
So, I
guess they're following that roadmap and doing the best they can for KKR. But somewhere I think, but if you're saying it's Kolkata Knight Riders,
there has to be.
There should be some kind of a Bengali touch.
Kolkata representation.
Yeah, kind of. But obviously not at the cost of the efficiency of
definitely,
the team.
Definitely.
I think Gautam Gambhir did a fine job. He made us champions and all that.
Yeah.
But then again, I feel that the batting looks slightly suspect.
Okay. So, cinema bhalobasha bole eto kichu korecho. Cricket bhalobasha bole, what did you do? Anything?
Cricket bhalobashi bole, ami cricket ei je nanan rokom celebrity cricket league feel hoy, sheigulo khelar chesta kori, porashona kori, cricket niye cricket follow kori. Ei cinema schedule er moddhe cricket follow korai is a huge thing. Airport, an obvious thing would be a movie on cricket, which I don't want to do.
Oh, okay.
Because it will be the most obvious thing. I don't like predictability, I don't like repeating myself, and I don't like doing things where I ask myself, yeah, so what? So that kind of a so what scenario I
I have a fascination. I have a sports movies.
I don't want to bore myself.
Okay.
I want to just constantly
keep it kicking, you know?
Keep it kicking.
Like
keep
that.
Myself pushing,
yeah.
Put myself in situations which are not my comfort zone and try to do things. And in all this, maintain a Srijit Mukherjee signature, or should I say an autograph.
Right. Oh, fantastic. So Srijit, ato to praises pecho. We all know about the praises. Kono ekta criticism, ba ekta khub kharap comment karo kach theke pete jeta mone ache, and that has like really struck very hard. We all talk about praises.
Ekta na hoye, koti, millions.
Okay.
There are lots of people who dislike me and my films, and I'm aware of them, and few of them I personally know also, which is cool with me, which is fine. The point is, those who love me sometimes compare me to the masters, to the legends, which kind of gets a lot of people's goat, which I totally understand. But the problem they miss is that it is not my doing. It is not my fault if my holding comes up with the great Satyajit-ray, or an article comes up where they are asking about Srijit, Satyajit, blah, 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 and all the predictable thing. But that is not my fault. I do not design it, I do not condone it. And frankly, it doesn't really matter to me.
Okay.
Whom I'm compared with, what I'm, the superlatives. Like the superlatives, you feel nice, but you don't depend on them.
Mm-hmm.
You don't. They don't drive you.
Okay.
A pat on the back is definitely appreciated, which is appreciated by everyone, I guess. But I'm not really claiming I'm a master filmmaker, I'm a great director. I don't even consider myself as a director to begin with. I think I'm a storyteller who used to tell stories on stage, now he's telling stories on a celluloid. Tomorrow he'll just say stories to his grandchildren. Probably sitting by the fireplace. Oh, we don't have a fireplace, right? Okay, sitting by the window. So, that's all. So, Shekhar, lots of people think that I think I take myself too seriously, and on that assumption, they say a lot of unkind stuff.
Okay.
Which is something which I find very laughable. And then again, the thing I was telling you, that this independent, dependent, multiplex, populist cinema, all that. I think let's not get into all the categorizations and vilify people. And oh, Shiji, toto. আরে পপুলিস মানে কি মুশকিল ভাই, আমি আমার মতো ছবি বানাচ্ছি, আমি আমার মতো গল্প বলছি, সেটা যদি আচ্ছা একটা লোকের ভালো লাগে সেটা তো আমার দোষ না, ভালো লাগছে লাগছে, এবার তোমার যদি ভালো লাগে মানে প্লিজ ফিল ফ্রি টু থ্রো রক এন্ড টমেটোস, হ্যাঁ মানে প্লিজ ফিল ফ্রি, অ্যান্ড বাট ডোন্ট পার্সোনালি অ্যাটাক দ্য গাই, বিকজ আমি তো তোমাকে পাকা গানে মই দিই, মানে আই জাস্ট মিন ইফ ইউ ফিল দ্যাট, ওকে ইউ ফিল দ্যাট, বিকজ অ্যানাদার থিং ইজ দ্যাট এভরিওয়ান what do you need to become a poet or a cricketer or a filmmaker or a rocket scientist or a brain surgeon? What do you need?
The kind of qualifications, the drive to become that?
No. You need a Facebook account. You have a Facebook account. You can be a brain surgeon.
Okay.
You can be a cricketer. Short term or not? ওটা তো আরেকটু পাটা ডান দিকে নিয়ে মাথাটা নিচু করে আরেকটু লেট কাটটা ওনার করা উচিত ছিল। এটা তো 20 বছর ধরে বলে যাচ্ছি, কেউ শুনছেই না। সিনেমাটা তো এইভাবে বানানো উচিত, সিনেমাটা কি খারাপ। গ্রান্টেড গ্রান্টেড যে মানে আপনারা অ্যাডভার্টাইজিং এর যুগ, হোর্ডিংস পড়ছে, অবভিয়াসলি ইট ইজ প্লেসড ইন দ্য মার্কেট, বাট ইফ ইউ নো, ওকে ইফ ইউ নো শ্রীজিৎ মুখার্জি লাইকস পানিং and if you don't like punning, don't watch his movies, man. That's simple.
Yeah.
You can't go watch his movie and say, yeah, what is he punning? I thought punning kind of no, you, let's say you dislike, how should I put it? You dislike stories about abnormal people or you stories about physical incapable. You don't like quirky topics. If you don't like quirky topics, if you write, like run-of-the-mill stuff, if you like predictable stuff, if you like Thorbori Kara Kamali film, don't watch Kaushik Gangoli films. So you go and watch a Kaushik Gangoli film, then you say, nah, eat a kennel, could be cured all the food. But at a conventional picture, so you know who stands for what.
Yeah.
Everyone has, every person, every storyteller has a particular style. He has his own signature, he has his own USPs and everything. So you don't know she will, by going the worst case. So anyway, so the thing is, what type of problem? Facebook. If you have a Facebook account,
you can rule the world. Facebook is the
You will be a poet, come filmmaker, come film critic, come cricketer, come rocket surgeon, come brain surgeon. Rocket scientist, come brain surgeon. You can do anything.
On Facebook.
On Facebook. On on Facebook. Nothing
yeah,
beyond.
Exactly.
Nothing beyond.
Nothing beyond that.
So, that's fine.
So, Facebook is also instrumental in Jatishar's picking of success, isn't it?
Oh, yes. Yeah. Absolutely. So, that is the thing. Now, so, the way you use it.
Absolutely.
I mean, the way you use it.
Yeah.
So, but then again, to be honest, I do get a lot of sensitive people also who criticize me a lot. Mm. But their criticism inspires me.
Yeah.
They when they criticize, I feel honored.
Okay.
I feel that okay.
Because they are learned, well-read people.
They have learned, well-read, and their criticism is, for according to me, justified.
And constructive also.
Constructive also and justified also, and they don't attack me. They attack the film.
Right.
They attack a thought. They attack a treatment.
Right.
They attack. I defend. If I can't defend myself, I lose. If they can't defend their attack, they lose.
What?
So it's a very fair exchange that we have.
Right.
But when uneducated people who have no grounding, no knowledge of what they're talking about, when they start sparring, that becomes laughable.
Yeah.
That becomes laughable. So that is the flip side of any social media site.
Yeah.
I mean, you meet great people, you meet intelligent people, you meet smart, vibrant people. People, again, I'm saying that these probably a large amount of them would not like me or my friends. I'm sure. But the thing is, when they speak, you enjoy the conversation, you learn from it, and you can match your wits with them.
Mm-hmm.
But then there is this other flip side also. So, criticism on a gas. I mean, quite actually, to answer, to cut a very, very long story short, that ami khub khub ekta mone rakhi na choto kotha khub ekta mone rakhi na karon at the end of the day jane amar to kyu amar chobi banan theke atkate parbo na ami amar moto chobi baniye jabo ebong seta odhikansho manusher ki ekhon bhalo lagche tokhon jodi lage ami porer chobi ta banate parbo jodi na lage porer chobi ta banate parbo na tole matter thik ache.
Wonderful. So that answers almost all our questions, like, you know, on different topics.
Yeah.
Okay. So Srijit, we have a few questions for you. Can't think much about it. We just expect a spontaneous answer.
Yes.
So top 5 directors apart from Srijit Mukherjee.
Demographics, as in Indian.
Tollywood, preferable.
Tollywood. The ones who are working now.
Yeah. Ones who are working now.
Ones who are working now. Okay, aparna-sen, Kaushik Ganguly, Shuman Mukhopadhyay, কমলেশ্বর মুখোপাধ্যায়, tough one.
Yeah.
It's a tie.
Okay.
Hmm?
All right. Fine. You can name both.
No, there are three.
Okay. Name all three. is it diplomatic?
No, it's not diplomatic. I have loved their work at some point of time or the other.
Okay.
So I can't really choose.
Okay.
Right. So it's a tie between Anindya Rai Chowdhury,
mm-hmm.
Aparna Ghosh, and another Anindya.
Fantastic. Param or Abir, marks out of 10. Param and Abir, marks out of 10.
As a human being?
As an actor.
Oh, okay. as an actor. Different schools.
Okay.
Totally different schools. Param is more Grotowski, Abir is more Stanislavski.
Okay. All right. Swastika or Nandana, the oomph factor?
Oomph factor would probably be Swastika.
Great. Kaushik Ganguly or Anjan Dutt, better director?
Kaushik Ganguly.
Ray or Ghatak, your preferred Ray. School of music?
Ray.
Okay. Sorry, filmmaking.
Ray.
Great. Hemanta-mukherjee, manna-dey?
My father would probably kill me for this, but I will go with manna-dey.
Okay, alright.
He was with Hemanta-mukherjee.
Oh, okay, alright. Indradeep or Jeet Ganguly? Indradeep Rajgupta or Jeet Ganguly?
Indradeep Rajgupta.
Any day. Okay, Sachin or Saurabh?
Again, as cricketer.
Cricketer.
As in objectively?
Yes.
Objectively, definitely Sachin.
Okay.
And emotionally, definitely Saurabh.
Okay. Srijit Mukherjee, the director, the actor. Who's better?
Srijit, the director, any day.
Any day?
Absolutely.
And
the close competition will be Srijit, the stage actor.
Okay. Okay. Director and the stage actor. So that's
that should be the tough one.
Great. Thank you so much for all this time that you spent with us, for answering so many questions we had for you. Thank you once again for being with Sholoana Bangaliana.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Please do spread the word. Jatishwar has been released in the US. And so please make sure your subscribers in the US go and watch Jatishwar.
We definitely would. And we love the movie.